When the country's intelligence chief gathered in the Senate today, they were all of one mind on a single topic. No question, the Russians will meddle in this year's midterm elections. Take a look what they said.
Yes, we have seen Russian activity and intentions to have an impact on the next election cycle here.
I agree with Director Pompeo's assessment about the likelihood of the 2018 occurrence as well.
And I agree with Director Pompeo, this is not going to change or stop.
Yes, it is not going to change, nor is it going to stop.
We have not seen any evidence of any significant change from last year.
Back now with the panel. You know, Chris Wray of the FBI was asked or said that the steps the intelligence agencies are taking are currently not, quote, not specifically directed by the president. I'm wondering what you made of that.
Well, I think he's trying to say, he's trying to straddle this line of thinking that the public doesn't believe that Trump is interfering in any ways with the Russia investigation, or he's just outright saying the president doesn't care about Russian meddling. And it is sort of jarring to see that lineup when every senior member of the intelligence community is at odds with the public statements of the president on Russia meddling.
Yeah.
I mean, these guys are up there saying that it's happening now and it hasn't changed when their commander-in-chief has repeatedly said that it never happened and that it's a hoax.
It's not just about trying to maybe manipulate elections. It's also about sowing discord in this country
exactly.
And raising doubts. And that they seem to have been very successful about.
They have, and they've done that in other countries. And I have to say, this is me as a wordsmith, I hate calling it meddling. John McCain called it an act of war.
Yeah. Right.
This was an attack on the United States of America. Not on just the Democrats. That was this time. It could be you the next time. They attacked our country. And not just the Democrats. 419 members of Congress, the majority of whom are Republicans, voted to sanction Russia to punish them for that. 98 senators, the majority of whom are Republicans, voted to sanction and punish. They instructed the President of the United States to do so. He swore an oath to faithfully execute the laws. He will not faithfully execute that law. Now, why, Jason? That's so off-brand for him. Because he's a tough guy. If somebody hits me, I hit back 1,000 times harder. He's tougher on Gold Star families. He's tougher on POD. He's tougher on Rosie O'Donnell. Why is he such a wuss on Russia?
Well, Paul, the thing you seem to forget here is who was president when all this was supposedly going on? Democrat Barack Obama.
Oh, he was not tough enough at all. But he's not there now. I'd be complaining about him if he was.
Exactly. We're playing a very complex
public game. He should be punishing them.
Congress told him to punish them. We're playing a very complex public game when it comes to the Russians, when it comes to North Korea, when it comes to Syria, and a number of things. Who I want on top of this, I want Mike Pompeo, Chris Wray, I want folks like that who are doing it. I don't need the president out there making a whole bunch of public statements on this. I want our law enforcement and our national security people out there doing it. And because we're playing if you guys are sleeping on the North Korea threat and you guys are sleeping on what's going on in Syria, then you guys need to
read that. We're talking about Russia.
Right, exactly. Let's talk about how
this is a very complex situation.
He's given aid to the Ukrainians. The absolute number one thing Russia does not want to see happen is us giving aid to the Ukrainians. He has reaffirmed NATO. The second thing that Russia does not want to see is us reaffirming NATO. He negotiated a peace in Syria, completely controverting what the wishes of the Russians were in Syria.
Why won't he
sanction when it comes to, I'm guessing that policy is to be tough with Russia. So if we're not doing it, there must be some other reason.
He also has secret conversations.
Probably because
we
want to go to war.
Yeah, there is another reason.
Asha, somebody who used to work at the FBI, I'm wondering, does it have, in your opinion, a chilling effect in the CIA, in the FBI, and other intelligence agencies, if people in those agencies, A, hear the president going after their agencies, going after the FBI, going after the intelligence community, and also call the Russia story fake news, a hoax? Does that have a kind of a ripple down effect, do you think?
I don't think it's going to have an effect on what they do day to day. They're going to keep their heads down. I mean, the FBI is going to monitor spies, neutralize them. The CIA is going to gather intelligence. But in terms of coordinating it into a comprehensive strategy to present to the president, feel that they are going to get an ear and someone who's going to be thoughtful and come up with a response, I don't think they're doing that for the reasons that Maria has mentioned. Clearly, we've already had reporting that they're afraid to mention Russia because it makes them upset. And there is here, as Paul mentioned, appears to be a very strong reluctance to stand up to Putin, whether it's sanctions, whether it's using the money that's been allocated to the State Department to counter propaganda, whether it's to direct the CIA.
Well, what the White House says is just the threat of the sanctions were enough to have an impact already. That's right. I mean, that was the
that's
line.
That's not what our intel chief said today. They said the Russians are still working to attack America.
I just listed three concrete ways that he has stood up to Putin, and then you just said the White House is reluctant to stand up to Putin. What about those Do we not think that Vladimir Putin wants the U.S. to give aid to Ukraine, where they have troops? Where, by the way, Vice President Biden said, go ahead and invade Crimea. Hey, Ukrainians, don't fight them. This will cause a war, which then told Putin, you know what, we should invade the Donbass as well. We have now given aid to the Ukrainians. Is that not standing up to Vladimir Putin?
I'm talking about the homeland and our electoral processes, and he is giving Putin the green light to go ahead and do what he's done before.
Or Congress has given him leverage to negotiate on other things like aid to Iran, like aid to North Korea that we have direct
threats. How do you negotiate on a covert act
and
covert operation?
It's not as if our intelligence directors are going to come out and put out a memo and say, here are all the specific things where we've caught them or what they're doing. Of course, they're still working through it and making sure that it doesn't happen. I mean, we can't have any foreign interference in the 2018 elections. I mean, period, point blank. I don't think anyone disagrees with that. But I don't want our intelligence chiefs to go out and telegraph every single thing. The last administration would telegraph all of their moves. This administration, they shouldn't do that. I think folks like Pompeo and Ray, smart cookies, I have a lot of confidence in them.